So this is preparations for a custom hardcover. Now, custom hardcovers are where you take actual issues of a comic book you have and you get them put together into a single hardcover volume. So here's one I did for Global Frequency, and this, you can see I made a custom graphic cover. This was done by Houchen Bindery. This one I did for Akira, the color ones. I had an extra set of these, so these got put together. So this one was done by Library Binding Company, who no longer do binding anymore, so I've been doing everything through Houchen and been very happy with what I've got. So I'm putting together a new order together. Here I have Optic Nerve. I went through and got a bunch of the issues, not first prints or anything. This one is a, let's see, third printing of the first issue. You can usually pick these up, they're not too expensive. And I had extra copies of some of the later issues. I had like nine extra issues of like 9, 10, and 11. So I went and I made sure to get all of those. And what I do is I put them, sandwich them between two backing boards. You print out a order sheet, which tells them, you know, what kind of binding you want to do, if you want anything fancy on this one. I really love Optic Nerve, so I'm getting some blue ribbon bars, some head and tail bands. I also, for me, a big thing is getting it Smythe Sewn, which helps keep the book you create really easy to open and flip through. That's a big plus for me. I just use a rubber band on all those. Now, before I do that, I always take, I have a pair of calipers, and I measure how thick the book is going to be. So that way I know in Photoshop where to start with getting everything prepped and ready for binding. So now I'm prepping everything for shipping. I'm using the diamond boxes that they ship the books with. Big thanks to Brandon Montclair for his suggestion of using these. You can usually get them from your retailer. If you ask them to put them aside for you, they'll probably be happy to do that. I'm getting a big order together. You can fit a whole bunch of books in here. I'm getting, since they never really did some nice omnibus hardcovers, I'm getting the Miles Morales Ultimate Spider-Man. I'm doing the Jonathan Hickman Avengers, New Avengers, Secret Wars stuff all together. And of course, Optic Nerve is going to go in here. Now, the books will stay pretty well preserved in these boxes. They're double thickness. If you have a really large amount of books where you have, it's twice the size and it's like this box goes in another box, then they're really super secure. This is going to be my first time sending them in just a single box. I guess this is a smaller order for me, but I'll pack this up. I actually have more books than I have room for in this one box, so I'll probably have a second box that gets sent out. I'll go to the post office, ship those out, first class or priority or whatever, and those will get out to Houchen Bindery. So I've gotten the measurements, the actual measurements from Tim Benson over at Houchen. The big ones for me are the total width and the total height. I'm going to go over to Photoshop where I've made a rough based on the calculations I had done earlier, but now I'm going to put in the actual measurements. Put in the total width that he sent, the total height he sent, and I like to work at 400 dpi when I'm sending files over to Houchen. It's high resolution enough that I know it'll print well. 300 dpa you can also get away with, but I do 400 just to make sure. Now I'm going to duplicate the work I did on the rough over to my new correctly measured Photoshop document. Now you'll see there's the sizing discrepancy. That's because in my rough, I made a mistake. I worked at 300 dpi. Usually I like to keep it consistent so that I don't have as many misalignments.
Now I'm going to go in and add guides. Guides are just useful, helpful things. You'll see them in Photoshop, but they don't actually show up in the printed version. It lets me see, because with these hardcovers, you need a border, three quarters of an inch border around the whole thing in order for the printed cover to fold over the edges of the hardcover. Here you can see I'm putting in the guides for the spine so that I know where that goes. Then I'm going to put in my last guide for the right border. And now I'll go in and put in my horizontal guides. And these are just to make sure that I have enough so that the paper wraps around the hardcover on the top and bottom, left and right. Now the last guide that I always like to have is a horizontal one that goes straight down the middle. There's an easy thing that you can do if you put in a vertical guide or a horizontal one, either way, and instead of putting a measurement in inches, you just type in 50%, it'll automatically go right to the middle. This was an easy calculation. 17 divided by 2 is 8.5, so that was easy. Now one quick thing before I move on about the measurements I'm doing. So what Tim sends over is very detailed, but for adding the guides there's a couple of things I need. So what I do is I take the total width, which in this case is 17 inches, and then I subtract the measurement of the spine, which in this case gives me 15.375. Now I'm going to divide that by 2, and when I do that it gives me the width of the border on the left side plus the back cover, which is 7.6875. Now that's going to be the guide on the left side of the spine. Then I'm going to add back in the spine measurement of 1.625, and that's going to give me 9.3125, so that's the right side of my spine. So that's how I get those aren't always listed out in the measurements Tim sends, but those are where I want my guides to be. So now all my guides are set up, and now I'm going to go about reformatting this so that it's correctly proportioned and I like the design and all that stuff. Now I've noticed that there's a discrepancy. What I'm using is composite modes in order to make a black and white drawing Adrian Tomine did appear blue. And I'm having a little trouble because when I duplicated my pieces, the compositing changed. And I've not been able to figure out exactly why that happened. But for the moment, I'm just moving on. I'm working on the back cover, making sure all of that's aligned and looking good. Now I'm going through and making sure the spine looks good. Here you can see why I like having that vertical one down the center, because it makes putting your title on the spine really easy. Everything snaps to these guides, so it's easy for you to make sure that everything's perfect. Now one of the things I did on this design that I really liked were these little bands at the top and bottom. I thought it made it look kind of fun and old school. Resizing those is pretty easy because I used a mask on these. So you can do your design and then you basically draw a box around it and say, okay, well, only show this much. My original measurement was a little small, so I have to create a little extra to make sure that the spine is the correct width. Now I'm going to duplicate that and replace the band at the bottom. It's just a little faster and easier than repeating those steps. And because snapping is turned on, it's really easy to make sure everything aligns properly. And then I can just delete the old band. Now one thing that helps the binders, helps Tim, is if you make registration marks. Now these are just little lines that are going to be on the exact center at the top and bottom, and just make sure that when they are putting the book together that they know, since once they can see where the center is, it makes everything lining up a lot easier for them. So it's the last thing I'm going to do to make sure that this is prepped for them. Now, to get the file over to them, what I do is I make a flat TIFF file. I don't like to send over these giant Photoshop files with all the layers. There's possibilities for fonts not to come through properly and all that stuff. So I save a TIFF without layers, and this makes sure that what I send them will be ready for printing.
Here we go. Okay, some Avengers. Oh, that's awesome. Gonna be a lot of Avengers in here. I was really looking forward to this one. Ghost in the Shell. League, the Nail, one of my favorites. Avengers. Secret Wars. Ultimate Spider-Man. I love that book. Wow. Oh my god, that's a huge book. Here we go. Optic Nerve. This one, I got the ribbon for it, and the end markers.
Thanks for watching. Click here to subscribe.